how Kraft Heinz has performed over the last 12 months compared to the disappointing performance pre-COVID? And what are your current and longer term views on Kraft Heinz prospects?
Well, I think that Greg's on the board, so I don't know that we're in a position to give advice on Kraft Heinz. We do, you know, we entered a in effect a semi-formal partnership with 3G many years ago when it was just the Heinz deal, and then went on to the acquire Kraft with our partners, and they've done more than. They hold up their share of things, and we do what we said we do going in, which is to be a financial partner, and they're more of the operating partner, although we participate to a degree in any big decisions, and they would listen to us. But we're not making any in terms of Kraft Heinz stock. That's up to somebody else to evaluate.
Yeah, the only thing I would add, Warren, is I think we're very comfortable with the fact that they put a strong manager in place in Miguel, and he's put a very good team in place at Kraft Heinz. So we're pleased with the leadership and management team in place. They're very focused on how they're executing as they've gone forward and rationalizing their capital structure and managing down their debt structure. So very pleased with the path forward with the existing management team.
Yeah, we feel better about the well, one of the, this is a more general subject, but one of the subjects I might write about in one of the future annual reports is the problems caused by the myths that people have about their own organization. And I've seen that so many times in various forms. And to some extent, the problem has become accentuated in the last 20 or 30 years because the CEO often, and works with the investor relations, but they say, well, we have to have constant contact with the analyst community. And of course, so they go on every couple of months and they repeat certain things about their company. And it becomes part of sort of the catechism. And nobody's going to go on 2 months after the CEO has said one thing and say, well, actually, that really isn't the way. they're not going to contradict themselves or change course. And so if you get these myths, and they can occur in a lot of different ways. I can give a lot of examples, which I won't do, as I tell my friends in corporate America, I really am not going to squeal on them. But there's a lot of mythology that gets handed down from one CEO to the next. Can the succeeding CEO say the guy that picked him, you know, was on the wrong course, or he's been telling you something that isn't really quite true? He can't do it, you know. And then he starts repeating it, and it leads to enormous errors, but it's hard to tell the story without giving examples, and I don't like to give examples. So we'll see when I write about it sometime. Charlie, you probably got some thoughts. He's had a ringside seat at he's been on boards that I haven't been on. I mean, and it doesn't just extend to business. It goes beyond that into education and a lot of areas. Well,
what's really interesting is the way you prattle out all the time. You're pounding back in even if it's wrong. And so one of my favorite remarks in the history of human remarks was by Sir Cedric Hardwick, who is a great British actor. And he said, I have been a great actor for so long that I no longer know what I truly think on any subject. And I think that happens to a lot of people. And it happens to virtually every politician.
And it gets embedded in corporations.
It gets embedded
and the trouble is now the CEOs speak out so often. So if they've got some crazy thing that they're saying about their company and they keep repeating it, the subordinates aren't going to contradict it. Charlie said they just believe it after a while, and it's dangerous.
Yeah, and of course the young people get these ideas after their liberal educations. They think that God has given them direct insights, and they're just as crazy as the politician.
Now, there's some old people that have that too.
Yeah, well, the old people are already crazy, but
they're going to die sooner. So
we have our oldest insanities. The new insanities are the young the young get.